This is Rebecca from chemistryismyjam.com. In this video, we're going to be comparing accurate versus precise measurements, and then we're going to look at what it means for a measurement to be valid. Let's begin with accuracy. Accuracy means that your measurement is close to the true value. In terms of a dartboard, an accurate throw is one that hits the bullseye. Precise means that several measurements are close together. So if we stick with our dartboard analogy, a precise thrower is one who every dart that they throw is hitting the same place. Now, a measurement can be accurate and precise, accurate but not precise, or precise but not accurate. These two things do not necessarily go hand in hand. In our dartboard example, the dartboard that you see here on the left has three darts that have hit the bullseye. That is both accurate because it hit the true value, the desired value, and precise because all three of the darts hit the same place. So precise indicates consistency. The dartboard in the center would be considered precise but not accurate. The three darts hit the same place, but they did not hit the bullseye. And then the dartboard on the right, which is kind of random, is not accurate because they did not hit the bullseye, and not precise because the darts did not hit a consistent location. It was not a repeatable measurement. So a dartboard is one way that you can think of accuracy versus precision, but I also want to show you what it might look like for a scientific measurement. In this scenario, you have a sample that you know has a true value of 5.0 grams. So in order for any measurements you take of this sample to be accurate, they must give you a measurement of 5.0 grams. Well, you take your sample and you weigh it three separate times. You can see that the first time you got a measurement of 4.6, then 5.2, and then 4.2. None of those measurements were accurate. None of them gave you the true value of 5.0. Also, your measurements have quite a bit of range in them. There's a lot of variability. So these measurements were neither accurate nor precise. They didn't hit the true value, and they were not repeatable. The scenario that you have on the right, all three of the measurements are the same, so that makes them precise. However, they were not correct measurements, so they were not accurate. This is a case where they were precise, but not accurate. So accurate means close to the true value, and precise means consistent. Several of the measurements are close together. Another concept about measurements that you should understand is what it means for a measurement to be valid. Chemistry is an experimental science. Throughout the course, you're going to be using glassware and scales and thermometers, all types of lab equipment that have increments labeled on them. Those increments indicate certain places where you can make a measurement that you know to be true, that you know to be accurate. Measurements at those locations are considered certain digits. In science, it is expected that when you make a measurement, you write down all of your certain digits and one uncertain digit. Every measurement that you make should have an estimated decimal place at the end of the measurement. Let's look at an example. Here you have a graduated cylinder, and each increment on the cylinder represents 1 milliliter. I look at where the liquid is located, and I can tell that it is definitely somewhere between 34 and 35 milliliters. So the certain portion of my measurement is the 34. I look at the liquid and it appears to me to be roughly 34.8 because I'm expected to estimate one digit. My lab partner looks at the same liquid and estimates it to be 34.9. It is absolutely okay that we got a different answer for that last digit because that is our uncertain estimated digit. Any scientist who is reading your measurement understands that your final digit is an uncertain estimated digit. So a valid measurement is going to include one uncertain digit in the measurement. In this video, we've looked at what it means for a measurement to be valid. Stick around as we continue our discussion of science and measurement by studying significant figures.